I have defined the load patterns in the last lecture. In this lecture, I will show you how we can define load combinations.